room, so I'm joking. But, like, here at the Chinese, I'm used to the New Beverly, I'm used to the New York Theater, Downtown Independent, and from a standpoint, I understand they want me to be a bit more commercial, but movies like The Craft, like Scream can be commercial, so many other things can be commercial, but The Wizard is not a movie that you think of. It wasn't a blockbuster, it wasn't one of those huge movies that made a shit ton of money. But you know what? It's one of the best movies ever fucking made. That's all I have to say. And like I said, I did this event before, and it was weird. My roommates were here. They had to leave because they get up at 3 in the morning to work 2 jobs a day. And my roommate Brandon's here, and I love him. And he turned to me like towards the end during Video Armageddon when I was leaning towards the screen. And he literally said, like, I've never seen you have as much fun at one of your events. And that's true. Probably the truth. I cried a little bit. And who knows about the alternate ending that's never been released?
What?
Yeah, exactly. We're going to find out about that. We're going to talk about that with Luke. But no, guys, this... I just want to say before anything, thank you. That reminded me, you know, I've been doing these events for a few years. I wanted to obviously be a host, but I also wanted to make movies and film and all that other stuff. And I've been able to do that thanks to these events and thanks to you guys. And I can't tell you how many people came up to me and have already thanked me. But I have to thank you. And so we don't have any chairs here because someone forgot to put chairs. But you know what? Let's bring down the star of Jeepers Creepers 2, which I'm not playing, because we're playing maybe another Jeepers Creepers movie. Let's bring up, please, Jimmy Woods, a.k.a. Now, while he's coming down here, I asked you guys to tweet. And you guys are super sweet. One of them was a little bit too sweet. I'm gonna read because I have one more Blu-ray to give out. It actually looks better. I don't know if they ran that through a 2K, but that was a 4K DCP that we booked, and that was 4K, but it looked a little grainy-ish, but looked better than the damn DVD, right? Okay, so I'm just gonna send out. I did say after I said say something, anything. I did say please to tweet hashtag the wizard and at the Chinese theaters. And the first person, I'm not going to name their name, but the first person to hashtag the wizard but put at Chinese, so he went to, you tweeted at someone named Hosan. I don't know what that is or who that is, but I appreciate the comments saying that you're cute. Thank you. You would have been the first person to win had you put at Chinese theaters, but you put at Chinese. The first person, you can come down here, you can come up here, and Luke will hug you for free, is actually Devlin Wilder. Is Devlin Wilder? Watch him get up with me. Wow. And you know what? You think I'm cute, whatever. Oh, are you here? Oh, there you are. You're wearing that green shirt in your profile picture. This is literally a 1080p Blu-ray copy. Master from Universal.
Thank you so much. So, really appreciate it.
Where are you from?
Southern Illinois.
I don't have a will for you to spend, but we can try. Southern Illinois?
I mean, I live here now, but yeah.
Okay.
In St. Louis.
Well, congratulations. You were the first one to correctly tweet, and now I'm getting one notification that I'm cute. So. And it was one of my roommates. So. All right. Well, thank you, dude.
Thank you.
Appreciate it. All right. So used to like doing these like huge movies that were huge franchises and rallying, and Luke here to turn to Luke just was like, I'm so on board. This is the second time we've done it. It's like the fourth time I think you've done it for this movie total. And let's do it. But yeah, no, it was really great meeting you.
Thanks very
much.
Really appreciate
it. See you out there. But yeah.
Thank you.
All right. So let's get this started. Luke, here's your microphone. Does it work? Test.
Test, test.
Okay, so Luke, how old exactly were you when you filmed this?
8.
You were 8. Okay, do you remember any of the audition process or what was kind of the first bit of acting that you did on the film? What was the first scene? What's the earliest memory you have for making this movie?
Yeah, I do remember a little bit of the audition process
cast it was Natalie Finn, who's like a, she's gone now, but she was like a legendary casting director. And so the process was kind of more about like getting the movie stuff than reading material, because there wasn't a lot to read. So it was more like, you know, I was the right kind of guy. I don't know.
You were just really quiet and awkward.
I was good at being quiet and awkward.
When did you, did you lose it right, like during audition, or did you, what? What's the story? Did someone pull out from your tooth?
I don't remember.
Where are you from again?
I don't remember. I'm from Northern California. I'm from really near Tahoe.
Okay, that's boring, but okay.
I love the spatial awareness in the movie. Like, we're at Lake Tahoe, and it somehow takes us days to get to Reno, which is right next door. Not only that, we're coming from Utah, which is the other side.
I'm pulling cheapers into the answer to this already, but they might not. But you really hated the scene where when they pull out the money and then the driver see it, the trucker code. But you really hated those freaking cows.
I didn't.
Did anything happen specifically?
I didn't have so much, you know, against the cows, but we had to like run behind them, and you know, cows can kick you, and like I've seen people get kicked, so I just didn't want to get kicked. It also smelled really bad.
It's
shitting the entire time.
was that just one day? Do you remember, or was that?
Oh yeah, it was really quick. It wasn't even a day. It was like. Yeah.
Well, I'm gonna just mash around here. So have you ever met Tobey Maguire?
No.
You've never met him. Do you know if he's aware of the kind of fan base that this movie has and the fact that he has a mullet?
It's such a good mullet, too. There's a couple
of mullets. It's a great mullet. Oh, look, I'm from South Louisiana. I know what a mullet looks like. It's a well-permed mullet.
I know that he is, he's aware of it only because I've seen, interviews of him talking about it, which,
Well, let's just jump right in. I'm going to be all over the place. So let's jump into the alternate ending. I went to a screening of this. Michael, are you still here? I'm not going to point you out, but Michael, are you still here? All right, cool. Michael's still here. So there was a screening done by this guy I don't like at all, but of The Wizard, back in 2009 at the New Beverly Cinema. And the director was there. What's his name again?
Todd Holland.
Yeah, that's right. I keep thinking of Tom Holland because of Spider-Man, but you know, I have I'm friends with Todd, but I have like three Todds and two Tom Hollands. It's very confusing. But no, most people don't know, and I don't know if you have much to add to this, but originally Universal didn't want that ending, the ending after Video Armageddon, where you go up to the dinosaur exhibits. Have you been there, by the way?
Oh yeah.
Ever since then?
Oh yeah. I stopped in every time.
You go there because of the wizard, or?
Yeah, I mean it's
okay.
It's dear to my heart.
It's very cool. I've been there once. I was like, I didn't even know. I was like going to Vegas in some weird way that Siri told me to go. And I was just like, oh my god! Like, I have to go, and I couldn't go in the door. The door was locked. I almost vandalized it, but I went in, but no, there's an original ending. Do you want to say it? Or were you kind of just get in the car and you do what with the lunchbox?
Originally, it was supposed to just toss it out the window.
That is the ending that Universal Studios wanted.
We made it this far, we won.
I love how she's sitting there with her legs like curled up. No, I love you, Jen. And that's another thing. One more thing. Shout out to Jennifer, because we were supposed to do another movie, and I've been trying not to do the same movie event again. And I talked to Luke, and we were okay. We were originally supposed to do Rookie of the Year. And Thomas Ian Nicholas, who I just hung out with at Comic-Con, was on board to come, and we were going to do it with a double feature of Little Big League. And so it looks like we're going to do A Kid in Aladdin's Court with Little Big League. Look out for that in October or November. But we were supposed to do Rookie of the Year. He was on board. And And then I immediately called Luke, and he was like, yes, let's do it. And you knew Tom because he was in American Pie 2. But no, like, you jumped on board on this, and this is the, like I said, you did it in the Minton, Texas, right?
We did, at Elmo.
Elmo
Draft House, yeah.
How did that go? And Fred was there for that.
Fred and Todd both came down, and they flew us down, and like made a whole event out of it. It was great. It was a lot of fun. It's great. And it's a great theater. She never been. It's super cool.
No, yeah,
Jenny, unfortunately, never shows up for any of these things.
Which is funny. Yeah, no, it's the truth, guys. I used the powers of Instagram commenting to get her, and it didn't work. She doesn't seem to have much respect for it. But anyway. So this movie here, I showed some trailers. Mother's Boys, in case you didn't notice, with Jamie Lee Curtis, starred Luke. Jeepers Creepers 2 starred Luke. And then, obviously, Little Big League starred Luke. Where does this movie hold in place of, you went on this run of a child, teen, young adult, like, films. Where is The Wizard the highest ranked to you, or where do you put it?
It depends on how you rank things.
In terms of least favorite film.
It was kind of like my first, feature. I was real young and really didn't know, anything about anything. But it didn't, it didn't make much money. So, it had, for as far as nostalgia value, it's like over the moon.
When did that start? Because here's the thing, I don't talk about my brother, but, I grew up watching this with him, and I had never, it wasn't like Mortal Kombat or Power Rangers or anything like that. It wasn't a franchise, it was just this one single film. But when did the nostalgia kind of kick in for this film? Because it's obviously huge.
Yeah.
I mean, looking at this crowd, and even I was overwhelmed when, 500 people wanted to friend me and come, and I'm like, okay, I didn't expect this. But when did it start?
Yeah, I mean, it has so much to do with, I guess, video games. Oh, I love all the inconsistencies in the games.
Especially the time clock.
I don't know the games well enough, except for Super Mario 3, to like pick them up. But I would love to know where they screwed up, because they really screwed up. it's like so bad. First of all, 50,000 level bag is like nothing. I've heard that so many times. They're like, dude, I killed Double Dragon last night. But you suck. You're not out of here. I bet I could have never tried it.
By the way, how many of you used the cheat in Super Mario Brothers 3 because you had seen this movie? That's a decent amount. Yeah, that's what I figured. But no, if you notice now, and not to get all political about Hollywood, but there's a lot of movies now that are all just kind of like big action comic book blockbusters. Middle movies don't get made. Certainly kids' movies, even like Rookie of the Year and The Wizard and Little Big League, they don't get made anymore. But where does this, what year did you realize, did somebody come up to you and be like, you were from The Wizard, or you were from, was it instantaneous? Because it did bomb.
It bombed.
It bombed. That's the Asperger's in me. It bombed. when did that start?
There was always a lot of love for it among gamers.
Yeah.
So even if the movie bombed in the theaters, it also actually it had a kind of bigger life at home video, right? So a lot of people watched it over and over and
that's
over.
That's where I saw it because I was in Umbria.
At home, right? So there was a good response for it at the time, but mostly kids and gamers and pretty much everyone else didn't take it seriously. It's an hour and a half commercial for Nintendo.
Do you know anything about the licensing and the product placement and what games were decided and anything like that for the film?
I know that they were, they were heavily involved. And I don't know, I don't know a lot of details, obviously, I was 8. But they were heavily involved, but unlike today where you have, corporate sponsorship with films, they're like all up in your business. I guess Nintendo was kind of like, here's all our stuff, just use it however you want to use it, but they weren't
actually, you know, I mean, as an actor, there's a method, there's a key to acting, but you play the best. I'm not gonna do anything but play this game face I've ever seen. I mean, you're really into the game, but I turned to him. I turned to him halfway through the movie, and I was like, "Is it really you playing something?" And he said, "No, like, but it looks like you're really into it, like Ninja Gaiden."
I wish I could tell you what I was looking at. I have no clue. It was always a tape of someone else playing, and which you can see in the championships. They cut away, and the guy is still playing.
Well, you can tell it's actually like a film projector. If you pay attention to the Super Mario Brothers 3, you can tell there's film projectors because there's scratches and stuff on the film because they had to run them. That's just the geek inside. But like, you can tell that's running off of a film loop, and you have to match that because you can't. It's not digital. You can't pause it and rewind it whatever.
You said let it run. It was actually kind of torture for me being 8 years old, and I wanted to play every one of those games, and I couldn't.
Did you at least get a free like Nintendo out of this, or?
No.
What?
But my I'd let go at this point. My big gripe for a lot of years was they promised me a copy of Super Mario 3. The producers were like, we're going to get you a copy.
So everyone write, yes. Everyone write to Nintendo and demand and then
get my cartridge.
I got one right here for you.
No, Brandon, roommate, remind me, like, with my check from the writing thing, we're going to get a Nintendo. No, we're going to go to Game Dude over in somewhere. Yeah. Game rocks, right? Like, anyway. No, so, do you have any iconic scenes in moments? Like, one of my favorite moments is obviously, for those of you who live in LA that are from here, the King Kong ride is very different, meaning it sucks now, when it was actually really cool at one point when it was practical. But you guys, like, that's probably one of the coolest things about the movie for me, is seeing like the behind the scenes of that ride, like that was never released by Universal, and it burned down in 2008. But what was that scene like, and what are some of your other favorite scenes?
Yeah, it was cool. It felt kind of dangerous. There was a fire, and you know that's really how it was. It was cool to see all that stuff. The other thing I remember is that they had a. They were like piping in banana smell from the monkey's mouth. Yeah, I mean, it was a, kind of a nice, fun touch if you're like on the ride. But if you're hanging out next to it for hours and hours,
was that when you? Do you remember when you did the Kong thing? Was it kind of like a half day, one day, or was it?
Oh, we were there a full day.
It was a full day.
Full day.
Was it two?
Oh, I couldn't tell you. It was at least a full day.
Okay.
And it got to be, it was too much.
Was any of the, just to clear the record, someone asked me this on Facebook, and I think it's a great question. Obviously, we see the Kong and the tram, and you go down the ladder, and you're right there. But the stuff with the elevator, and coming up in that basement where we boo the villain, was that Universal, or was that a set?
Definitely. It was all, you know, on the lot at Universal, on the back lot, but many, you know, various sets all around. That's the other spatial continuity thing, which makes no sense. Like, we run away from the theater, and we go get on a tram and, like, drive halfway around the lot, and on the, and then we're somehow, and Kong is above.
It was actually funny because my roommate, like I said, Brandon, he saw it. I showed him the first time. He said, "Oh, I'm going to introduce you to Luke, and I want you to meet him, so watch it." And he might have gotten emotional and cried, maybe. Like I did to me.
Well,
here's the thing. Yeah, exactly. I called you out.
Thank you.
The thing is he pointed out, he's like, when they stab the tire and then they release it, he takes the knife and goes, ha ha ha. But then when they get the tire, they take the knife out.
And it's not a knife, it's a tuner.
Yeah, exactly. And continuity.
Royally.
It's every time.
remember the shoot was? Was it a month, 2 months, 3 days?
It was two miles, a little over two months.
Okay.
Like we're all around. I mean, we're in all those places, Nevada and Iowa, around California, all that stuff.
Were you actually in a casino in Reno?
Oh yeah.
Really?
We spent a ton of time in casinos. And there I actually, I got to hang out in the arcades and I got to play some of the games.
Yeah.
Okay, so let me ask you and be honest with you, are you nearly as good as your alter ego?
Of course I am.
That's the obvious answer. Is that looking in the eye? Is that for real? No. But it's weird. I talked a little bit about old Hollywood, and when I say old, I mean 80s and 90s. But when I say like 90s Hollywood, and this is basically 90, it's 89. It was a very different time. It was a very different growth. And now you're still a working actor. You're on True Detective, which was an epic show. Still is an epic show. But
hopefully coming back.
Yes. No, you didn't die, so.
Oh, I'm not coming back. I'm not.
Oh, you're not. I double checked that. But yeah, apparently was wrong. No, but like with these movies and kind of the time of Hollywood, what was it like? Kind of. I mean, there was a lot of kid actors. I mean, there's like Free Willy, like Jason James Richter. There's Macaulay Culkin, Home Alone, and you definitely went on a run as a teen scene young child actor. What did you meet any of them, especially Macaulay Culkin, and what can you tell me about him?
I never met Macaulay. I knew his brother, Rory.
Oh, one of the killers in Scream 4.
Yeah.
It's been out for 6 years. Come on.
But it was we were all a group of kids at that time. Do you remember? Do you guys know who Charlie Korsmo is? You remember him?
Yeah.
Do you remember him? He's not acting anymore. He's like
Noah Hathaway, and I'm Facebook friends with him a few times, and now he's just posting nude selfies. Okay.
You go on in different directions.
You just have a mustache and one hand in your profile picture. What do you think? I mean, what was it like for the transition for you when you've done Mother's Day, you've done, all these other kind of young adult kid films, and then you were in like Jeepers Creepers 2. Did you notice Hollywood changing, and what did you think of it? Like,
the big shift didn't come until a little bit later.
What year?
Probably, after Jeepers Creepers, mid-aughts.
I literally say 2004 was the last great year.
Pretty much. And the big shift was you can't say no, but there's very little middle class in Hollywood anymore, which means there's huge tentpole superhero movie, and then there's tiny indies, and there's nothing in between now, which was, for all the, kind of people who were in the industry, that was our bread and butter. That was like, make a living. It's gone. So that was around the time of that shit.
Except for the African American culture, they get movies like Girls' Night, which opened to $31 million, and it's fucking R-rated hilariousness. But what are you kind of up to with acting today? Where do you what as you grew up? Like, I mean, you were such a kid when we really got to know you best.
Yeah.
But what do you love? Like, what shows do you watch today? What movies do you watch today? Like, what's some of in the last 10 years been your favorites?
I was actually a huge fan of True Detective. That was like one of the best shows for me. I'm a huge Wire fan. I'm into like true crime and stuff like that. But anything sci-fi. I can't wait to go see Valerian. I'm into like everything. It's fantasy.
For coming tonight, I'm sure I need a food ticket to believe. NG Box 3D. I don't think I have any more questions. I want to turn it over to you guys. Does anyone have a question? Yes, you, right there. Brian.
So, who did they use for the person who played your sister? Like, was that like someone's daughter, or was that...
Was that your real sister?
Yeah, I'm wondering.
Or was that Jennifer when she was young?
She was, you know, we had so little interaction. It was like, hey, nice to meet you. We were going to shoot like 4 photos.
And then bye.
And then I never see you again, basically, which is how it works a lot of time. She was specifically cast for that. She didn't have to look.
Okay. You know, so she...
Which did happen. And there's actually a lot of it in the movie. There's all kinds of people who are like relatives, you know, in various places. Ben Savage is in there, who played his world. And there's all kinds
really?
Of
wait, people. Where is Ben Savage?
Ben is, the kid who he goes up and he runs up and he hugs. It's Snoopy? It's some like dog.
Yeah, the panda.
Panda.
And
he's wearing, you know, Vision streetwear. He's a cast member.
A lot of savages in this movie. Okay, yeah, you did.
So this was kind of at the height of Fred Savage's power, right?
It's so Goldenberg.
Sometimes. The movie didn't do that well, so not a lot of people were really happy on that. But I also, you know, I never played it during production, sort of silly, but, you know, when it finally came out and my neighbors at the time got it, they got all the way to the last level and had a really hard time, couldn't beat it, and so they decided to call me over to come and beat it for them. And I had never played it. So the first time I played it, I played it on the last level.
Oh,
and
that's
I died a lot.
It's a really hard last level, but I think Super Mario Bros. 2 is a lot harder.
A lot harder.
It's a lot harder.
It's true.
You're just going too fast. But yeah, you right there.
You might not know this, but the answer to this, but there's a very prominent pager call in the casino for a Johnny Love, like paging Johnny Love. Is there any significance to that at all?
I think he knows it by their reaction.
Okay.
I know. I'm sorry. I have no idea what that.
But you recognize it in the.
But it's so prominent and it's weird.
Yeah, they keep that scene just to do a page for Johnny Love.
I know there is, and unfortunately you have to ask Todd because he's the only one who.
Does Todd have a Facebook or a Twitter? Oh, really? A Twitter, Instagram?
No.
Todd doesn't see me as the guy that has an Instagram. It's like he
in front of a mural. Not really. He has a Twitter. He does have a Twitter.
Okay.
Tweet at him. Ask him. He's a super nice guy.
He's a phone
caller,
too. All right. Anyone else? Yes. You see me on the stairs with the cool hat.
Yes. Hey, you're the nicest guy. You're great in this. Is two questions. Is Christian Slater cool in his prime? And do you have any memories about him in filming this?
Did you ever see him do coke?
That dude at the end had to have been doing. You ever notice how he like does his
thing? He's just like,
and then he's like, I'm coming back in a second, and then he sprints. In my mind, he was always going to do coke.
You do it, AJ. What is his destiny?
Christian was super nice. We had so little time together, so I interacted with him in a very limited way. But he was super, 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 super cool. I don't know why he, like, I watched this movie now, and I don't know why he signed on to it.
Does anyone know what he had done, like, right before it?
Oh my god.
That's the next thing, Brandon. Roommate, you're watching Gluten Me the Cube. It's on the car. The pizza truck.
Yeah,
it's odd. He has such a normal character in this movie.
Even he was like a teen heartthrob at the time.
Okay.
You know? He took the Heathers and all this kind
of like
cool, edgy stuff where he's like a lead and then he does this. It's just like, what?
Do you know if this was destined? Like, I mean, obviously bombed, but it doesn't matter because we're all here. But like, was it destined to be this big, great universal picture? Like, I mean, like we talked about Hollywood now, it's all about Avengers and, you know, Ben Affleck doing multiple superheroes and complaining about it later. But like now, you know, we have these universal movies back in the day. Where was it destined to be this great big hit, or was it kind of supposed to be? Let's make $35 million, and we've made a good buck.
Yeah, pretty much that. At the time, you got to remember, like, video games are such a huge industry now. That was not the case. So Nintendo was still kind of new, and still a lot of people were like, you know, I don't need that. So it was big at the time, but they didn't spend a lot of money.
Yes, would he be playing PS4? One terabyte edition?
He would be making a really good living at video game competition. That's a full-on thing now. You can make six figures. Competing, it blows my mind actually to see it, you know, like as I get older, that it gets bigger and bigger and bigger because when we did this, everybody was like, what? Video game competition? Are you kidding me? That's
video games are so new. I mean, compared to what they are now, back in 89 or 88 when you filmed this, it was unheard of. It was, and I remember my mom calling in, did anyone play Starbucks?
Yeah.
When Starbucks Adventures came out on GameCube, I could not beat the last level to save my fucking life. And I swear to God, I called that Nintendo hotline in the magazine, and she got a bill for like $163. Because they charge like $350 a minute, like where did they went from broke in cattle cars to nothing. All right, any more questions? Yeah, one more right here.
Do people on the street often, like you're maybe in a store or something, and people go California?
Well, there was a screening actually where he in Texas, the one with Brett Savage, where he refused to say California.
ago he did say it, so. Props. But no, do they?
I don't know. I guess I look pretty different these days. I don't get it too much.
Is he not? To me, he looks exactly the same, except he's a little taller, a little bit more like facial hair, and a decent watch. So, all right, if there's one more question, there's two more we'll do. Or with us, one point. There's a lady clinging to the one last one. Yeah, I can't see.
I just have a comment. You mentioned earlier that you would love to know what the inconsistencies in the games are, and I actually watched a video earlier today on YouTube that points out every individual
in this movie.
Yeah, in this
maybe
movie.
Maybe from your movie.
NES inconsistencies. There's a video that points out the last one.
No. God bless whoever did that.
Can't see. No one is. Okay, cool. No, dude. Like Lou, you're the man, dude. Give me a hug. Seriously, right up there.
Thanks to Corey.
You know, that's one of the people that actually thank me. You know, seriously, like guys, I've shown Mortal Kombat, which is kind of along the same lines, video game adaptation. Showed Power Rangers and. It's not so much anyone forcing me, but I've always been scared to do things that are a little bit non-commercial at this complex. But they've always welcomed me, everyone from Levi and Eric to Louisa, especially to Jennifer. Once again, give her a round of applause, sorry. I've always been a little bit hesitant, but when I called her and I told her, I was like, okay, we can't do Rookie of the Year, but there's this movie called The Wizard. She's like, okay, well, what's it about? And I looked over to her, and like we were crying at the end, both simultaneously. And this crowd that showed up was more than I could ever ask for. You guys were the best audience I've ever had. And this may not be my favorite movie in the world that I've shown, but this was definitely my favorite audience. You guys are great. And I think that you'll maybe see Luke up again here, maybe in September for some Jeepers Creepers stuff. And maybe, you know, a little bit later for another baseball movie. But, yeah, keep in touch. My Facebook is facebook.com/Corey, K-O-R-Y, S. Davis. I don't know how this event page spread. Usually with my pages, even when we sold out, like, Mortal Kombat, I got, like, you know, maybe 173 people are interested in your event. I had over 500 people interested in this event. And you guys really packed the house, and I love this movie. I'm glad you guys had a good time. I'm glad you guys interacted with it, and everyone have a blessed day and a good night.